Doug, did you at any point in this game consider pulling Carson for Jalen? And is there a point at which you would consider that?
You know, with the way the game was going and the elements, and we were just, really a score from putting ourselves back into this football game, I did not consider that.
Jeff and then Dave Zangaro.
Doug, right before the half, Josh Sweat recorded a sack, and you didn't call a timeout there. Could you explain why?
I honestly, I don't remember the.
There was like a minute and 40 seconds left. The clock, the Browns just allowed the clock to run off, and then they called a timeout with 1 second left. I was wondering, was going to be a third down there. What
was it? It was on second down.
Yes. And Josh, Jeff, recorded
honestly,
the sack.
Jeff, you're going to have to, I can't, honestly, I do not recall the play. I'd have to, can you walk me through it a little bit more, honestly?
Yeah.
I know we were trying to save we were trying to save timeouts to get the ball back, possibly, you know, to use the timeouts on offense, but there was a reasoning. I honestly can't think of the reasoning right now. We had discussed it on.
Okay, real quick then, did you bench Jason Peters or did he pull himself?
Ask me tomorrow, because I'll definitely give you a better answer tomorrow. I'm sorry about that.
Okay, well, then can I ask this one? Did you bench Jason Peters, or did he pull himself?
No, I did not. He had kind of injured himself, and so he had come out.
Dave and then John McMullen.
We pulled him out. Hey, Doug, is Carson Wentz going to start next week?
Yes.
No question about it.
Yeah, no questions about it. He's our starter.
Go ahead, John.
Okay. Hey, Doug. Sorry about that. All the moving parts on the offensive line, you just mentioned Jason, Lane. I think you started. This is the ninth different group. How does that affect the offense as a whole?
Well, it's difficult. Part of the offensive line is having that group together. You know, all five guys, and we just haven't had that this season. And it's hard to get that continuity and that consistency up front. It's just a challenge because the thing is with the O line is these guys they rely on each other, right? And the more they play together, the more they anticipate. What a defense might present, and anytime you have as many moving pieces as we've had, it throws that rhythm out, and so it's been a challenge this season, no question.
Kristen and then Tim McManus.
Hey Doug, what is your message to your team after this loss? I mean, what needs to change? What has to be different?
You know, the message to the team basically is pretty simple. We are where we are because of the mistakes that we've been making, coaches and players. Now, that's everybody included. But this will be a great test for our football team. This will be a great sign to see really who's in and who's out. And that was the message. That's the challenge to everybody. And that's that's just where we are. It's a matter of now. Really challenging the leadership of the football team, challenging the coaches, challenging, the guys to, keep this thing together. There's six football games left. We still have an opportunity in our, in our division. But it's really going to challenge all of us moving forward.
Tim and then Paul Domowicz. Or Paul, if you're ready, go ahead.
Yeah, Doug, I understand your point about continuity on the offensive line. But with Sam Alu back and them missing Myles Garrett, did you expect better protection for Carson today, particularly since your run game was also keeping them from getting too aggressive?
Yeah, it was really good to get Isaac back out there. And again, he it's his first time back in the offensive line, you know, since early in the season. And so, you know, I think I'll have a chance to watch the film to see how he does. But, yeah, there was some good, you know, some good things in the first half that we were able to take advantage of. And then the second half and was really, you know, Kelsey got the injury there in the second quarter. And then Lane, then JP, and so then the second half became a little bit different. But, that's that continuity that I was talking about.
Tim and then Chris Franklin.
Doug, there was a lot of talk this week about you guys being mad and identifying these ways that self-inflicted wounds that you're going to clean up. What does it say when the same exact things happen?
It says we got to coach better. It says we got to play better. It says we have to pay attention to our jobs, plain and simple. You know, and that's these games come down to, you know, three or four plays, and that's kind of what this game here today came down to. It was about four plays that, you know, that were mistakes by us. The turnovers, costly penalties. So we have to fix it.
Chris and then Jimmy.
Doug, you had defensive linemen continually to jump off sides. Have you given consideration of possibly even benching or having them stay off the field for a period of time, or any other form of discipline to go ahead and stop this? Because it seems it continues to happen.
No, you know, I mean, obviously I wish we had, you know, if you have a lot more depth at positions, maybe you can do that. Maybe you can bench guys, but when you dress the number of guys you dress for games on, you know, on Sundays, it's hard, you know. Again, it's a concentration. When I talk about the details and execution, that's part of it, right? That kind of stuff falls in line with turnovers or, you know, lack of takeaways, whatever it is, and those are the things that have been holding us back.
Time for two more, so we'll go Jimmy and then Zach Berman.
Hey, Doug. Obviously, benching Carson will be a huge decision with potentially major organizational ramifications. If there were a scenario in which you thought benching him in-game was the best move, would you have full authority to do that on your own, or would you need a second or third party to turn their key, so to speak?
Look, I think if you get to that spot, whether you don't start him or you bench, I think you're sending a wrong message to your football team that the season's over, and that's a bad message. And you know, we have to work through this. Times, you know, when times get tough, it's, you know, sometimes that might be the easy thing to do. This business is about work. This business is about, you know, detailing, having ownership, things I talk about with the team. And that's what we got to do. That's coaches and players. That's not one guy. You know, it's bigger. This sport's bigger than one guy. And we all have a hand in it, and we all have to fix it.
Last question here with Zach.
Hey, Doug, on the pick six and on the safety, what was your perspective of what happened on those plays from the play call to the execution?
Yeah, I mean, the play call was something that, as far as the first pick six, we just we broke down in protection. We had an opportunity, I think, there on the throw to get the ball out into I think Jalen Reagor's hands there. We just broke down in protection, got hit as the ball was being thrown, and it popped up. They made a play. The one in the end zone, we just, again, it's just an awareness thing. We just got to know when the clock is going off in your head, you got to throw it away, you know, in those situations like that. And again, something that, you know, it's been the first time this year. We were there earlier in the game, and we were able to, you know, complete a pass down there and just try to stay aggressive as possible. But something we'll learn from.